Our lifeline question answers we are going to see. Forests are very important for us. So along with the questions, we need to understand the importance and relevance of forest for us. First is explain how animals dwelling in the forest help it grow and regenerate. So how does animal help forest to grow and regenerate? So there are various ways, like the animals. The animals may be herbivorous, they can be carnivorous, they can be both, that is omnivorous. So they live in a forest, and they are every one of them, they are part of food chain. So animal, the seeds dispersal, you know, reproduction in plants, animal facilitate them. They are one of the you can say important factor in dispersal of seed from one part of the forest to other. Then the excreta of animal, and when they die, and when they are decomposed, their excreta is decomposed, they act as manure. They act as a manure for the plants which are upcoming. And the humus which are created by the dead plants and animal, when the microorganisms or the decomposers works on it, they are rich in nutrients, and they are the basic building block of plants. Means they are incredibly important or very necessary for mineral providing, or you can say mineral source for plant. Explain how forests prevent floods. So there are various ways in which you can see. If this is a tree, this is soil, okay, these are roots. First of all, the forests are natural absorber of rainwater, and it allows them to see. When the rain falls on a tree, this rain doesn't fall directly to the soil, but in fact it dips like this. So this rain, which if tree is not there, it will flow like this. But because tree is there, it dips and it will go inside the, means it will increase the ground level, ground water will be increased. Then when there is no tree, if the water comes like this, it will just flow, taking all the upper, the important layer of the soil. So if water is there, it will stop the, if the tree is there, it will stop the water. So the prevention of flood is also the major task of these trees, whose roots binds the soil. What are decomposers? Name any two of them, and what do they do in the forest? So decomposers are minute, very minute microorganisms. There are certain insects also. They work on those which are being decayed, which have lived their life, like the plants and animals. So the microorganisms that convert the dead, this is very important, dead plant and animal to humus, they are known as decomposers. The fungi and the bacteria are certain examples. So what they do exactly in the forest? They are recycling agent. When the plants and animals, some of them, they have lived their life, they die. So these decomposers recycle and convert these dead matter into humus. This humus mixes with the soil, forest soil, and these are the nutrients provided to the plants. So in fact, these decomposers are having a role to maintain the required or necessary nutrient balance of nutrients in the soil. Explain the role of forest in maintaining the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. There are two parts in forest. One is flora, one is fauna. So what happens here is, the flora, that is the plants and trees, they take oxygen and they take carbon dioxide and they give out oxygen. while the fauna, they intake the oxygen and take out the or give out the carbon dioxide as they are respiring. So forests play a very important role. Forest works like a self-sustaining or self-regenerating system. All the product or whatever is produced in the forest is utilized in the forest. So animal, when they are doing respiration, they take oxygen and release carbon dioxide, while on the other hand, the plants take these carbon dioxide and they release the oxygen because they are doing photosynthesis, they are producing their food. Even all the waste, you know, all the waste are also converted into beneficial substances in a forest. That is why there is no waste, and this is the role of forest in maintaining the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide, O2 and CO2. Explain why there is no waste in forest, which just saw in the previous question, that whatever is produced is consumed in the forest. As we just said, that these forests are self-sustaining, they are excellent, perfect example of natural recycling factories. All animals, they may be herbivorous, they may be carnivorous, and they ultimately depends on what? They depends on food. They depend on food, because herbivores eat plant and of course plant products. Then carnivores, they eat herbivores, and the microorganisms, they act on dead remains of animal and plants. They produce or they make humus. So whatever is being produced by forests is ultimately the outcome of forest is intake of forest. The forests are maintaining, or they act as a network, a food chain called food web, and nothing goes waste in forest. Everything is consumed, everything is being produced in a way, or just because they are to be consumed. List 5 products we get from forests. So we get fruits and vegetables, we get timber and wood, the turpentine latex, that is the rubber raw product we get from forests, spices, resin, gum, the medicines and the herbs. Fill in the blanks. The insects, butterflies, honeybees and birds help flowering plants in pollination. Pollination. A forest is a purifier of air and water. Herbs form the lowest layer in the forest, lowest layer. The decaying leaves and animal droppings in a forest enrich the soil. They enrich the soil. Why should we worry about the conditions and issues related to forest far from us? If some deforestation is going on, say in Delhi, the Kerala people should not be worried about it. Is it the case? Or if something is going on on Michigan or New York, the Kenya people should not be worried about. This is not the case. You are living in a world which is governed by certain parameters, environmental parameters, the temperature, the total earth temperature. So everything happening anywhere, directly or indirectly, affect the total, the combined, the collective environment, temperature and the conditions of the world. So these forests are very important. We should really, you know, be concerned about it. We need to be very careful and concerned about the issues which are related to forest, because if there is no forest, there will be more floods, there will be a lot of soil erosion. See, forests are basic factor as far as global environment is concerned. If the forests are reduced, that is deforestation happens, that area lead to global warming. It will add up to the global warming, and which is ultimately going to affect the whole earth, not only you, because you are living nearby, but if you are far off, it is going to affect you. Forests are the dwelling place of animals. So if deforestation happens, it is going to endanger the life and the environment together. Then if we don't have trees and plants, where will the fauna will go? The animals will not have any food and shelter. And apart from that, not even this, conditions or, temperature, global warming. There is one more thing, that forest is giving us wood. It is giving us fruits, medicines. So these products will not be available if we keep on cutting the trees and plants. Explain why there is a need of variety of animals and plants in a forest. That means we are talking about biodiversity. Why we need different types of flora and fauna. So variety of animals and plants living in forest build a rich biodiversity, and this biodiversity is very important, because every plant and animal, they have a role. There is a system being built by the Almighty, the God. And just for example, herbivores, they are needed to eat green plants and to provide food for the carnivores. The carnivore eat the herbivores and check that the herbivores population does not increase more than a level. The biodiversity make forests more productive. The stability and resilience it makes. So the diversity or biodiversity make forests more productive, stable and resilient. Just see that if there is no grass, all herbivores would die. If there are no carnivores, the herbivores will eat all the plants, and there is shortage of food, there will be shortage of food. And if there are no decomposers, then what will happen to the dead plants and animals? They will actually pollute the system, they pollute the environment. So due to such a biodiversity, a balance in nature is maintained. Here the artist in this figure has to put some labels. Like, so we have to mark this. We have all these available with us: cloud, rain, atmosphere, carbon dioxide, oxygen, plants, animals, soil, roots, water table. So start with this cloud. This is the atmosphere. These are the rain coming down. This is carbon dioxide, because oxygen is delivered by the tree and plants, and carbon dioxide being taken. While the deer is intaking oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide. These are the plants, these are the roots, this is the soil, this is the water table. Which of the following statement is not correct? The second one. This statement is saying a lot. Plants and animals in a forest are not dependent on one another. This in fact is wrong, because they are dependent on each other. Microorganisms act upon the dead plants to produce humus. It produces humus. So these are few question and answer on forest. Forests are very important for us. Even if we are not living there, that doesn't mean that their importance can be ignored. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.